In this lesson, you're going to learn how to create responsive websites using CSS, and this is something that you have to look into before you start creating websites today, because today, most people will be seeing websites on cell phones, tablets, and a computer. So if your website is not responsive when people were to view it on a cell phone, then your users are not going to get a good user experience when they visit your website, because everything is going to look so tiny on their cell phone. So we need to look into responsive web design when creating websites. And this is why we're going to do this in this episode. Before we get into the project I want to do with you guys, we're going to create a basic portfolio website. So it's really important you guys don't take this lesson as something that you don't really need to learn, because it's very important that you guys learn about responsive web design. Okay? So to demonstrate what I talk about when I mention responsive web design, I want you guys to take a look at the example here we're going to build today. Inside my browser, I have a basic website with an image banner on the top. I have an image underneath the banner, and I have some text next to it. So I have a header, I have two paragraphs, and when I view it inside the browser on my computer, it looks totally fine like it is. Now, if I were to take the same website and view it on a tablet, then I want the layout to shift around so that the content is still readable on a tablet. And if I were to scale it down even further on a cell phone, then we still need to make sure the content is readable. So if we were to actually take the browser here and rescale it, you guys can see that when I hit that tablet point where when the wrapper I have around my content starts to, you know, reach the sides of my screen, it's going to start to shift around the content like so. And now it becomes readable on a tablet. Now, if we were to scale it down even further to a cell phone, you guys can see that we got rid of the banner, because it's not really a banner that you can see on a cell phone and it makes sense. So I decided to get rid of it when I got to the cell phone size. So this is what responsive web design is, and it's something that is really important for you to learn when you get into web development. Now, before we start coding anything, there's one more thing that's really important to tell you guys when it comes to responsive web design, or just in general, designing a website, which is that you should always design for cell phones first, and then after you design for the cell phone, focus on larger devices such as tablets and then a computer. And the reason for this is that it makes it a lot easier when we need to program the website and make it responsive. Now, again, this is an opinion that changes from person to person. Most people today will tell you that you need to design for cell phones first, and some people will tell you need to design for desktop first. And again, the way I recommend doing it is for cell phones. So that's the way we're going to do it in this series here. So the first thing I'm going to do inside my index page, which you guys can see I have nothing special inside of it right now, except for a link to my style sheet, is that I'm going to include a piece of code at the top here that allow for the different devices to scale the content in your website when you view it on different devices such as cell phones, tablets, and the computer. So the code we're going to include here, right on top of the link to the style sheet, is going to be what we call a meta tag. Now, a meta tag is used to include additional information on the website when you view it inside the browser. And again, this is information that you can't see in the website, only the browser can see it, and it has to be able to see it, okay? So we're going to include a meta tag. M-E-T-A, then we're going to say space because we need to add a couple of attributes to it. We're going to include a name because we need to tell what kind of meta tag it is. This is what we call a viewport, which means the width and how the content should be displayed inside the device. After setting a name, we're going to set something called content equal to double quotes. We're going to set this one to width equal to device dash width. And again, you guys may notice I used no spaces inside the name. And what this basically does is that it tells the device that the edge of the website should follow the edge of the device. Now we're going to go ahead and add one more thing inside the content attribute, which is going to be something called initial dash scale equal to 1.0, which basically tells the device that it needs to scale the content inside your website so that it matches the device. And if we don't have this, then, for example, the text might appear really small inside your cell phone. So we need to have this as well. I'm going to go and close off the meta tag, and we're not going to have a closing tag at the end because we only need to have the information inside the opening tag. I'm going to save it. And now we can actually get started on actually creating the content for the website. Now, inside my root folder, just to show you guys, I have a couple of documents. I have my index page, I have the style sheet, and I have an image folder with the two images inside of it. So I'm going to go back inside my index page, and I'm going to create the banner first. So I'm going to say we have a image tag that has a image inside my image folder / called banner dot png. Then I'm going to set an alt so we can actually understand what's inside the image. So we're going to say mmtoots banner. And then I'm going to go ahead and go down to next line. The next thing I'm going to create is a wrapper to have all the content be inside of, so I can actually center it inside the website. So we're going to give it a class set to wrapper. I'm going to go in between the wrapper tags, and then I'm going to create an article tag, which basically just means that we're creating a section that has similar content inside of it. And we're going to go ahead and give this article tag a class name. So I'm going to set this one to img-info. So we have some info on the image I'm going to insert right next to the article. And inside the article tags, I'm going to include the h2 tag, which is going to be the title. And I'm just going to call this one yay! Exclamation mark. We're going to include a paragraph. And the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to go inside my browser. I'm going to go to a website called lipsum.com. And inside of here, you can actually generate lipsum text, which is placeholder text you can use if you don't have any real text so far. And I'm just going to go ahead and copy some of the text we have in here, like so. I'm going to paste it inside my paragraph. And again, if your text editor does this where it just makes one big line, you can go up to view and then say toggle soft wrap. Now I'm going to go ahead and I'm actually going to go ahead and make two paragraphs here. So I'm going to close the paragraph up right before it says UT Vivira. Again, it's not really a real language, so I can't really pronounce it correctly. I'm going to go ahead and start a paragraph right before again here. So now you guys can see we have two paragraphs. I'm going to go ahead and save this. And underneath here, underneath the article, I'm going to create the image, which is going to be next to the text. So I'm going to say we have a image tag. The source is inside an img folder called me.png. And again, if you don't have my images, you can just go and use your own if you want to. And inside the alt tag, I'm just going to say my name because I'm on the picture. I'm going to save it. And now if we were to go inside the website that we have here, refresh, you guys can see we have something that doesn't look entire right yet, but we do have something inside the website. So I'm going to go back inside my coding here and go inside my style sheet. And as you guys can see, the only thing I have in here is just some default styling to get rid of margins and paddings inside the website. Now, what I'm going to do here is we need to focus on cell phone first, meaning that what we need to do is we need to see how the website looks inside a cell phone. Now, the next thing we're going to do is I'm going to show you guys a tool we have built inside the browser as a default that we can use in order to see the website on different devices without having to use, you know, any kind of advanced plugins or anything for the browsers. So what we can do in here is I can right click on my website, and at the bottom here where it says inspect, you guys can see we then get this little tool here on the right side. And inside of here, we can actually see the code of the website. And when I hover my cursor on top of, for example, the image that I have on top of my website, you guys can see that it actually highlights inside the website, so I can actually see what is inside here in the code. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this device icon we have up here on the left. And when I click it, we can actually see it in different devices. So you guys can see right now it says iPhone 6. So I can also change it to iPhone 5, iPad, you know, whatever device I might want to see it inside of. So right now I'm going to set it to iPhone 6 because that's what I want to design it for. So what I want to do first is I want to get rid of the banner we have on top of the website when I'm inside this view here, which is a cell phone. So I'm going to go inside my style sheet, and at the top here, first of all, I want to set the wrapper to something like 100% because our content is inside a wrapper. So I'm going to say we have a class called wrapper, and I'm going to set the width to 100%. We don't need to set a margin because we're not trying to censor anything when we use 100%. Underneath the wrapper, I'm going to say we have the banner, which I called img-banner, I believe. If not, then we need to go inside the index page and actually add that. And as you guys can see, we don't actually have the class applied. So I'm going to say we have a class applied to the first image at the top called img-banner. I'm going to copy this because I want to add it to the other image as well. So I'm going to scroll down to the second image and change it to img-me. Okay, I'm going to go inside the style sheet again. And I want to change the banner to not appear when I'm inside a cell phone view. And again, right now we're designing for cell phone first, so we only need to focus on the cell phone inside the style sheet. So I'm going to set this one to display none, which means that right now we won't be able to see the banner inside the website. It's just going to not appear. So if we were to go inside my website, refresh, you guys can see that the banner disappears. And again, we will make it reappear again once we do actually scale up the website. Going inside the style sheet, I'm going to go underneath the image styling, and I'm going to start styling the box that we have the text inside of, the H2 tag and the paragraphs. So I'm going to say we have a class called img-info, curly brackets, and then I'm going to set the width to 100% and save it. Then I'm going to style the actual text inside this image info container. So I'm going to copy it, paste it underneath, and say we have an H2 tag inside of here. And I'm just going to go ahead and style a bit of the text. So I'm going to say we have a padding because I want to make sure that it has a bit of spacing from the top of the screen and the left side and the right side of the screen. So if you guys see it inside the website, you guys can see that it goes all the way up and touches the corner. We don't want to have that. So I'm just going to create a bit of padding. So I'm going to say we have 30 pixels from the top. We have 30 pixels from the left and right side. And then we have 20 pixels from the bottom. I'm going to save it. Then I'm going to go underneath here and add a font family. Now I didn't import any special font, so we're just going to use Arial. Go down to next line, add a font size. Going to set it to 50 pixels. Go down to next line, add a color. Just going to set it to hashtag 111, which is a really dark gray color. And then I'm going to add a line height. So we're going to set the line height to 44 pixels. And if I were to go back inside the website, you guys can see that we now have something that looks a bit more normal. We could scale up the text a bit if you want to because it's inside a cell phone, but I'm just going to go ahead and leave it here for now. I'm going to go back inside my style sheet, copy what we styled of the H2 tag, go below, and change the H2 to a paragraph. So now we're changing the paragraph styling inside the website. Now I would like to get rid of the padding from the top, so I'm just going to set it to 0 pixels, and I'm just going to keep the other two the same. I'm going to keep the font family the same. I'm going to change the font size to 16 pixels instead. The color is going to stay the same, and the line height is going to change to 24 pixels. Then I'm going to go ahead and save it and refresh the browser. And now you guys can see that we have some text going on inside the browser. Now before we continue, there's one more thing I want to point out, which is that right now, as you guys can see, the wrapper does not go 100% of the width, even though we told it to, but that's just because we didn't change the image size yet, so that's going to change once we change the image size, okay? So we're going to go back inside the code, and underneath the text here, we're going to change the image that appears next to the text. So I'm going to say we have a class called img-me, which is what we gave it the class name as. And I'm going to set the width to 100%. And then I'm going to save it. Go back inside the website, refresh. And as you guys can see, the website changes and now looks like a cell phone format. So we didn't actually need to change the size of the header. The image just basically prevented the wrapper from actually showing the entire width of the website. Now, the next thing we need to do here is we need to design for tablet, meaning that if I were to increase the width of the website, it needs to change the layout so it matches something we would actually see inside a tablet. So this is where we start getting into the CSS part that actually allow for us to change the layout using CSS only. So if we were to go underneath my code here, I'm going to create something called a @media_only_screen and parentheses. Now just to explain what exactly we did here, the media statement tells our CSS file only to run the code in between the curly brackets here if the statement afterwards is true. So right now we're saying that if we have a screen and the screen has a minimum width set to 768 pixels, then it's going to run the code in between the curly brackets. So what we need to do is we need to change the code that we have up here when we get a minimum width of 768 pixels. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the image banner because I want the banner to appear when we get to a tablet format. Now what I'm going to do inside the developer mode is I'm going to change it from iPhone to iPad. And as you guys can see, the width of an iPad is 768 pixels. So the browser should now change the styling when we reach this tablet width. So I'm going to go inside my styling. And the first thing I want to do is I want the top banner to appear again. So I'm going to find my banner styling, which right now is set to display none. I'm going to copy it, paste it down inside our curly brackets down here at the bottom, and then I'm going to set the display to block, which means they want to show it again now that it's not shown inside the website. Underneath here, I need to also set a width to 100% because I want the width of the banner to go all the way from left to right. And I'm also gonna go ahead and give it some spacing at the bottom so it doesn't touch the image and the text that we have underneath it. So I'm going to set a padding bottom to 30 pixels. So now if I go back inside the browser, refresh, you guys can see that we now have a banner at the top and there's some spacing below the banner. I'm gonna go back inside my website here. And the next thing I'm going to change is the wrapper. So I'm going to copy the wrapper from up on top of the code here. Copy. Paste it in. And I want to change the width from 100% to 600 pixels. Now, one more thing we also need to do is we need to make sure that we have a margin set to 0 auto because I want to center it. And now the next thing I want to change is the text right next to the image we have inside the website. So I'm going to go up here. And right now, I think the image info looks fine because I would like to have a width set to 100%, which means that it's just going to stay inside the wrapper from left to right. So I'm just going to go ahead and pick the H2 tag here and the paragraph tag because I want to change these two. So I'm going to go ahead and paste them below the wrapper. And again, we don't need to have all the code. We only need to include the code that we want to change. So right now I want to change the padding. So we have maybe 20 pixels from the top, 0 from left and right, and 0 pixels from the bottom. I would like to keep the font family the same. So I'm just going to delete it from here. And the font size is going to stay the same. The color is going to stay the same. And the line height is going to stay the same. I'm going to go down into my paragraph and I'm going to change the padding. So we have a 20 pixel padding from the top. We're going to have 0 pixels from left and right and 0 pixels from the bottom. I'm going to save it and I can just delete everything else from in here because I don't need to have that either. And again, I'm just deciding here. I'm just sort of playing around with my styling in order to get something that looks right. So I'm just going to go inside my website, refresh. And as you guys can see, it looks slightly different. Now the last thing I want to change is the image down here. So I'm going to go inside my code and I'm going to grab the styling for my image and paste it down inside my styling down here. And I'm going to delete the width because I would still like it to be 100%. And instead, I'm going to give it a padding top set to 30 pixels and save it. Go inside my browser, refresh. And if I were to exit my developer tool by clicking the close button in the right corner, and then rescale the browser instead, it might be a little bit easier to see what we actually did. So if we were to go down inside cell phone format, you guys can see it looks like this. And if we were to scale it up and we get to tablet format, you guys can see that it changes the layout quite a bit. So this is how we can do responsive web design. Now we're going to do one more, which is to add the styling so we can see it inside a computer as well. So we're going to go back inside our code and I'm going to copy the entire section here that we had with the media code and just paste it below here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just delete everything we have from in here because I like to start from scratch. And I'm going to change the minimum width inside the statement here. So instead of 768, I'm going to say 1,000 pixels, which means that now I personally think that we need to shift around the content to make it fit inside a desktop computer. So inside the curly brackets, the first thing I'm going to change is going to be the wrapper. So we're going to choose the wrapper. We can just choose the one from up here, paste it in, and I'm going to change it to 1,000 pixels. Now we already set a margin 0 auto in the styling up here, so it's already going to have the styling applied inside the desktop view. So I'm just going to delete it. Then I'm going to change the image info, which we haven't actually included inside our first media query. So we're just going to go up and get it from up here and say that we have image info, copy it, paste it in. And now I want to change the width to 50%. I would also like this one to float to the right side. And this basically just takes all the text and makes it go to the right side of my wrapper. Now what I would like to do is I would like to take the image and put it on the left side of the wrapper so the content goes next to each other. So we have an image and we have the text. So I'm going to take the image, which is up here, which is image me. I'm going to go down, paste it below here, and I'm going to change the padding top to 0 pixels because we need to get rid of it again. And I'm going to set a width to 50 pixels as well, just like we did with the image info text. I'm also going to go ahead and set a float to the left side. And now what I need to do is I need to change a couple of things to the text. So I'm going to copy the text we have up here, the paragraph and the H2, go down here, paste it in between the image info and the image me class. And then I'm going to change the H2 tag so we have 20 pixels from the top, 0 from the right, 0 from the bottom, and 30 pixels from the left side, because I would like to have some spacing between the text and the image on the left side of the text. Okay. I would also like to change the H2 tag so we have 30 pixels on the left side as well. So I'm just going to paste it in here. And this is basically what we need to have inside the code. So I'm going to save it, refresh the browser, and as you guys can see now, the layout looks different again inside a desktop view. So were to rescale the browser, you guys can see that it changes the content according to the width of the browser. And again, this is going to work inside cell phones, tablets, and desktop computers. So this is basically how we create responsive websites. I hope you guys enjoyed. In the next episode, I think we're going to create a portfolio together so we can actually see all the stuff we learned so far actually being used in order to create a website. So hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time.